I'm Rhonda, I'm 24. I live in Richmond, Virginia, and I'm addicted to sucking my thumb. My first memory of sucking my thumb would probably be when I was about 4, and I just never grew out of it. I suck my thumb pretty much everywhere I go. I can suck my thumb while I'm driving, I can do it at the grocery store, at a coffee shop.
The thumb sucking was cute up to a certain age, but it's getting to that point where she's just too old now.
When I'm in public sucking my thumb, I just get just very strange looks from people that think it's weird. Like, it kind of makes me feel important. Maybe there is a part of me that likes the attention, and that's why I do it. This is my blanket, or what's left of it. I smell it while I'm sucking my thumb. What I'll do is I'll take the blanket, wrap it around my finger, and then suck my thumb and smell the blanket.
If it's time to suck her thumb, she's gonna suck her thumb, and she really doesn't care where we are. She basically has that attitude like, if you don't like it, then don't look. Are you really sucking your thumb right now? We're like in a public store.
Yeah, I mean, do you have a problem with it?
I mean, it's kind of embarrassing. You're my older sister and you're sucking your thumb.
I only suck my left thumb, and after a few hours, it looks like, you know, when you were in the water for too long and your hands get really crinkly? That's how my thumb looks.
Just the fact that the thumb becomes wet over time, the whole nail bed can start to fall apart, and people can develop even yeast or fungal infections, and even have ulcers that can develop on their extremities as a result of this.
I think when I was more stressed out was when my parents were getting divorced. So I think it resulted more into sucking my thumb because it was more comforting for me, because that's really all I had at that point. I do feel like I get sick a lot more than the average person, probably because when I do suck my thumb, I don't wash my hands or anything like that.
She's getting at that point where she's gonna have a career and hopefully settle down and get married. Is she gonna be sucking her thumb at the same time as her baby? I just think that's a little ridiculous.
When I'm at work, I will suck my thumb during the day if I'm feeling like stressed out. My career goals are to be living in New York, working on Wall Street, but I don't think that sucking my thumb is gonna stop me at all.
Are you ever gonna stop sucking your thumb?
Why does it matter to you? It's not like it's hurting you.
I can't even understand what you're saying right now.
I don't think that sucking my thumb is a big problem. I don't think I'm hurting anybody by sucking my thumb, so therefore I'm probably not gonna stop anytime soon.
Hello guys, welcome to Putt Putt.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you guys doing today?
Good.
I met Steven my freshman year of high school, and he definitely had a lot of jokes towards me about sucking my thumb, and he definitely shared his opinion very openly about what he thought about it.
Rhonda's thumb sucking back in high school was like kind of cute, but now it's getting kind of ridiculous, kind of crazy. She's an adult. She needs to get rid of it.
See, watch this. I can do it with my thumb in my mouth.
You better not.
See, I can multitask.
Yeah, but you wouldn't have to. You just got two hands. Maybe if you lose the blanket, you'll lose the thumb.
You want to smell it?
No, you've had the thing for too long. You don't wash it. No, I'm good. No, I don't want to smell it. It doesn't need to be smelled. It needs to be thrown away. I have never smelled the blanket, and I will never smell the blanket. You gotta lose that blanket. It's embarrassing. You don't need it. You're an adult. What if you stop sucking your thumb?
But I'm not ready to let go.
But it could stop you from getting a job or finding someone.
Well, if that were the case, then you know, then I would think about it some more.
Have you ever thought about like talking to somebody or seeing somebody, therapist, hypnotist? Don't you think talking to them could like release your feelings? And
I've crossed the idea. I think it would be kind of interesting to see what their thoughts are on it.
Well, think about it.
I'll keep it in mind.
Well, honestly, in 10 to 20 years, I hope to be married and, you know, have a family. I don't want to be sucking my thumb because it's not something that, you know, to be proud of. The only time that I'm not doing is when I'm in the shower, brushing my teeth, or blow drying my hair.
Lately, I've been starting to realize that, you know,
I'm 24, maybe I should stop. And I thought that seeing a therapist would kind of answer my questions about as to why I haven't been able to give it up.
What do you think that you gain from it?
It just puts me at ease. It kind of relaxes me. I worry a lot about things, and so there's always something running through my mind.
Have you ever had any periods of time where you've stopped?
The only time that I've not is when I've lost my blanket for a couple days.
Okay.
When I lose my blanket, I usually don't suck my thumb.
Take me back to that time when you first started to try to stop sucking your thumb.
It was just constant. Like, my parents were trying to make me stop. My babysitter was trying to get me to stop. Later on, like, when my parents got divorced, it was really there on a comfort basis for me. I know we're talking about an object here, but...
Right. But it was a stable object. Mm-hmm. And what was going on at that time with your parents' divorce? How was that for you?
It was hard because, oh no, let's not talk about that. No. Sorry.
The thumb sucking with your blanket is a coping skill. It just may be a socially unacceptable coping skill, but it's still a coping skill. How willing are you to try something else to replace that?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think that I would like to try it to see, like, where it would go from there.
One of the things that I can give you today is called a progressive muscle relaxation, and it's really good for when you're feeling anxious and feeling stressed out and you want to try to calm yourself down. All it is that you tense the muscles starting from your head to your toes, one at a time, and release them. Mm-hmm. As you do it over time, it continues to help you relieve stress.
I fear that I'm not going to be able to have that comfort that I'm used to, sucking my thumb.
It's going to be a little bit of risk on your part to be willing to try a couple of different things and see how that goes.
Okay. I could definitely give it some thought, maybe.
Okay.
Talking to the therapist today got me definitely thinking about some things. She opened up my eyes to maybe other alternatives and let me see that, you know, maybe I could change. I do see myself eventually stopping. I don't know when. I would hope to give it up someday when I'm ready.